Aloha everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome to another video. Got another edition of Watch Me Work on a High Elf Chariot, and I want to pick up with these lions here. I might break this video in two, because I think the next highlight that I do on the front paws here is probably going to finish up that area. And to be honest with you, I can't remember what my highlights were for these back areas back here, so I'm going to have to go guess, or at least go look at a book. But anyway, for right now, actually I might be able to get away with this, kind of depending on what I do. I think I can paint the claws and give us enough video for 15-20 minutes worth of time. But let's go ahead and paint the what I think is going to be the final highlight, because this thing is just so bright at this point that I can't imagine it going on very many places here. I mean, this is just so stark compared to everything else. Alright. Speaking of stark, I had the recent, I guess fortune, I don't know what you would call it. I recently watched the Game of Thrones stuff that everybody's been talking about. I don't, unfortunately, have, I don't even have television anymore, except for the one that I pan the camera into, and it's on the fritz. But, we used to have, like HBO and all that kind of stuff when I was growing up, and then we got rid of it, and I finally just got rid of my television altogether, because to be honest with you, I don't really watch it for any reason. But heard a lot of people talking about this HBO or this Game of Thrones thing, and so I picked up the DVDs from my local library, and they're all right, not too bad. I like the production value of it, definitely. It's quite nice, but I don't know, there's a few decent episodes, a few decent characters, and so it's kind of cool. Let's see here, let's do this. Let's put this back here, here. I was able to see, I was able to get the DVDs for the first season, the second season, and then discs 1, 2, and 3 for the third season. So I've only seen through episode 6 of the third season. But so far, it's all right. It's one of those, to me it seems like one of those series, like some of the, like the Weiss and Hickman stuff from the old Dragon's Lance era, wherein I can watch it, and I'm kind of different from other people when it comes to fantasy and sci-fi stuff. There's certain characters that are really, really popular to a lot of people that I just freaking hate, and I mean just, like, wish they would die kind of characters before the end of the book. I'll probably take a lot of flack for this, but especially in the Weiss and Hickman stuff, the mage Ryslin, oh my goodness, it just, the few books that I've read, it's like, dude, would you just please expire? You're just taking up words on a page. And there's a couple of characters in the Game of Thrones that are just like that. I know they're supposed to be, like, quote-unquote good guys, but, oh my lord, they are just awful. I mean, absolutely awful. And, you know, it's one of those, you know it's bad when you start rooting for the bad guy to actually wipe this person out. And, so, I don't know. It's interesting, but I don't know if I'll watch any more of it after the third season's over, or after I see the third season. But we'll see. We'll see. Some of you are probably wondering which characters I hate, so I'll go ahead and tell you. I can't freaking stand Catelyn Stark. Absolutely hate her. Actually, pretty much the entire Stark clan is pretty much on my bad list, with the exception of Arya and Jon, because they're basically the rebels, and I can get behind a rebel. The other ones just seem a little too whiny. I don't know. to me, just they're not really good characters. I mean, I know they're supposed to be the good guys, but I just don't like them. But hey, you know, to each his own, I suppose. I remember when I said I didn't like Lord of the Rings, I had all kinds of comments. I can't believe you don't like Lord of the Rings, oh my lord. So I can't imagine what the comment section is going to look like after this, or what kind of emails I'll receive. So, whatever. Yes, and by the way, if you're just joining us, I can't stand Lord of the Rings either. So, woohoo. Alright. Basically for the same reason. Most of the main characters, the ones that you're supposed to, like, really get along with and, you know, learn to love by the end of the books, I can't freaking stand. Could not, I mean, just absolutely hated them. Hated them. So, I don't know. That's just me. I think I'm really over-highlighting these areas, some of them anyway, but that's all right. It's okay to over-highlight. Sometimes. It's your world. You can do what you want. Come on. Right in there. Just like so. There we go. Alright. I actually think that's gonna be it for this highlight set on this area. Front forepaw area. Now, let's, what can I do? I can whistle. I think I'm going to do the claws. I really need to do the paws, but I don't know what color paws should be. I suppose I could look it up on the internet, but that would take up video time, which you guys probably don't want to sit here and watch me look up what color a lion's paws are supposed to be. So I'll do that off camera, but let's paint the claws now. And where, oh where, shall I find... There it is. Uh-huh. Yay. All right. And let's get a little bit of this onto the palette. What is that color over there? Oh, that's actually the next color I need. Fantastic. Okie dokie. There we go. So we're going to set that to the side. Color. And let's paint the claws. I see an area here on this paw that just does not want to take paint, so I'm probably going to have to repaint it several times. But that's alright. I don't mind as long as it looks good in the end. And I'm getting color off of the claw. I'm actually getting on the paw itself, so I'll just make the claw bigger. That way I don't have to go back and fix a mistake. That's what we call a quick little tip for you. If you ever get paint just barely outside of the area where it's supposed to go, just make that area bigger. It'll keep you from having to go back and fix your problems. Or fix your screw-ups. Alright. Now, let's pose. Let me get a little bit more of this paint, the highlight color, and try to get this area painted a little bit, because it doesn't, for some reason, that one little spot just doesn't want to take the paint. I don't know what it is. How very odd. Oh well. C'est la vie, you know? Alright. A little more paint here. A little more water in the paint. By the way, I want to keep saying this for a while. If you're just joining us, and you've never, ever, 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 ever seen an episode of Watch Me Work before, You're probably wondering why I'm not telling you what I'm doing or like walking you step by step through how I'm doing what I'm doing. It's because this is not a tutorial video. These are specifically designed so that you can just kind of cut the YouTube on. Or if you're on our website, first of all, thank you for visiting HEPminis.com. But if you're watching this on the website or on YouTube, it's just an opportunity to watch a little small piece of art get created, however long it takes, in real time. And maybe you can paint along at home. Maybe, like a lot of other people have commented, you find my voice relaxing. And you can watch these after a hard day at work or something. Help you relax a little bit. You know, whatever. Or you can just watch it for funsies or have it playing in the background or whatever you want to do. It's up to you. Alrighty. Let's see here. There we go. Just like so. Alright, I think this guy's going to turn out really, really nicely. There we go. I had somebody comment on one of the previous videos that they were thankful that I'm doing these as regular lions as opposed to the white lions that GW has on the packaging. And to be honest with you, the reason I'm doing that is I just didn't like the look of the white lion. I thought it was really, really odd. It just seemed really strange to me. And so I just said, you know what? Well, just paint up a regular lion. And I don't know if I'm going to do the desert base like GW has on their packaging stuff. I think I'm probably just going to do a standard sort of dirt-like base. Because I think a desert base, to be honest with you, would really clash with this type of lion's fur. My desert would be strikingly similar in color to this sort of ivory buff combination, beige-ish, whatever it is you want to call it, creamy eggshell, I don't know. And I don't think the lions would stand out very well. So, odds are pretty good. I will do a simple dirt-style vase and just let it go at that. I had initially thought about doing something like having it be sort of a swampy mud type base, to where the wheels of the chariot had actually made ruts in the ground. But in order to do that, because the chariot is so far back on the base, I mean it's basically touching the back edge, I would really have to extend the base an extra, I don't know, 30 or 40 millimeters, and at that point, you know, it doesn't really look like a model anymore. It looks like something that I tried to extend the base so that I could do something cool behind the model. And to be honest with you, you know, the front of the miniature is the focal point anyway. The front and the sides. And, you know, if you've got ruts in the mud or something like that behind the model, it's a nice feature if people can, you know, take the time to look and notice things. But you really just don't have that kind of time when you're trying to get people to look at your stuff. I mean, you've got just a minute fraction of a second to capture their attention, basically, for the most part, from one angle. And so I'm just going to paint this sucker up without the ruts in the road. Trying to sort of pseudo cover these white spots. I don't think it's going to work. I think I'm going to have to mix up that highlight color for the fur again. But that's okay. Excuse me. I've had a bit of a respiratory problem for the last couple of weeks. Was only sick for a day or two. Well, I guess it was three or four. But to be honest with you, that's a far sight better than I've done in the last couple of years. Generally speaking, when I start having respiratory trouble, it's a week and a half, 2 weeks, sometimes three, that I'm just stuck in bed. And so I was quite happy to only be in bed for a few days. That was nice. I think a lot of it has to do with my change in diet and the fact that I've been really vigorously exercising. Even on the days when I was sick, I was still getting out and running 5-6 miles a day. I know that's probably not the best thing that the doctor would recommend, but I'll be dipped if it didn't work. Alright, so let's do that there, get a little water in the paint, and paint a happy little lion claw. Alright, there we go. Let's see if we can do this. I'm not really concerned about getting this perfect. Maybe I should be. Maybe it would come out better. Gosh, Christopher, what's wrong with you? Don't you strive for perfection and excellence and things like that? It depends. I like to look at things and ask myself, you know, in 10 years, is this really going to matter? Most of the time, the answer is not really. Which makes the decision very simple. It really irritates a lot of the people that I work with. Some of them are really high strung, and you know, that's fine. But for me, I'm very laid back. I've been high strung, or I was for many years, and it's just not a good way to live, to be honest with you. It's too annoying. You're always on the edge. Always wondering what's going to happen next. You know what? That's cool. Whatever happens, happens. And if it doesn't work out, just change your approach. Try something different. That's the best way to work. I think, at least. For now. Might have a different opinion years from now, but I kind of like thinking that way for now. Alright. I think that's pretty good. Although I must admit that his claws here on this foot have been sculpted in such a way that it makes it look like rhino feet, which is interesting. And I just looked at the LCD screen of my camera, and it's blinking at me, which means I need to plug it in. I've got the small battery in there for now. I can only record for like an hour before it starts crapping out on me. The other battery, the 6-hour battery, is charging. But with a little bit of a plug-in, we have no problem whatsoever. Now let's see here. 18 minutes. Well, I need to hurry this thing up, don't I? Probably so. Alright, so let's paint this sucker. Big old claw right here. Oh yeah. Speaking of the Macho Man, if you ever get the chance, when you have some spare time, years ago, because it was when I was still in college and I was bored one night and went to the mall and was browsing through used DVDs, I found used CDs. I found a CD called WrestleMania the Album. And it was these very, very odd songs actually sung by World Wrestling Federation wrestlers. One of whom was the Macho Man. And I gotta tell you, it's a very, very strange song. But it's worth a listen just for a laugh, because if you're going to learn one thing from the song, it's that Macho Man says, dig it, dig it. And oh, does he ever. Boy. Check it out on YouTube. I actually found a video for it a couple of years ago, and it is just hilarious. I have no idea what the song is called. But you can probably find it by typing in like Macho Man album or something. I don't know. But yeah, it's one of those things you have to watch if you're looking for a laugh. It's just absolutely fantastic. Really great. Alright, there we go. There's those claws, the fronts of them at least. I guess that would actually be the backs of the claws now, wouldn't it? Mm-hmm. Alright. There's some more clawage going on. And then these. And then that one. And huzzah, I think we're just about done. Except for the ivory. Gotta add the ivory. Otherwise, it doesn't look like a claw. It just looks like a yellowish blob. You gotta add the ivory, Christopher. Please. Add the ivory. Okay, fine. Alright. A little bit of ivory. Just for fun. Alright, here we go. Ivory, ivory, ivory. Here's an ivory. And a little bit more ivory. Hmm? Like that. And then a little bit on the tip of this claw here. And then this one over here. Hooray. And then we come to the other claw. And we put a little ivory on the tips. Just like that. And this. Yay. And in this one. Oh yes. And this one. Mm-hmm. Hooray. Okay. And then maybe we do the backs of them. Like that. And that. And that. And I think we're going to call that pretty much done. Fantabulous. Alright. Well, that was exciting. Let's take a look at the lion here. Let me hold it by the... I guess let me hold it by the back feet. And let me see here. Let's kill some of the light. Kill some of the light without killing the camera shot. How do we do this? There we go. I used to be really, really, really good at doing this. Something like... So? Maybe? Kinda? Get him in the shade there. A little bit shade. Okay. You know what? If I would close one of these, that might help. Okay. There we go. At some point, I'm going to find a good angle. There we go. That's actually not too bad. You can see the nice cuts and contours and the things of the legs there. So, looking really, really sharp. I like it a lot. The claws look pretty darn good. Still got to figure out how to paint the inside of the paw right there. But other than that, I like it. So, that's all I got for you guys today. If you have any comments or questions, please put them down there in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you have not already done so. I really appreciate you guys watching. Thank you very, very much. God bless you all. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you all in the next video.